Will robots ever have so much autonomy that they will start taking over the world? This question has always seemed a bit far-fetched, a dystopian idea that could only happen in a science fiction story. But what if I told you this is already happening, at least in the virtual world? At least that's what defenders of one of the most controversial and frightening theories of today, the theory of the dead internet, claim. This theory suggests that humans have lost control of the internet, with real people's interactions becoming insignificant due to the rampant growth of information exchanged by bots and AI services. This would mean that the ones in charge around here nowadays ain't humans, it's the robots. This story was born as a bizarre conspiracy theory, but time has shown that it may not be so conspiratorial, nor so bizarre after all. The theory began circulating around 10 years ago on social networks and specialized tech websites, but it was only in 2021 that the most well-known publication on this topic emerged, a sort of manifesto of the dead internet theory, which remains the primary reference for researchers in this field. It was a text that was published on January 5th in this technology forum by a user who was named Illuminati Pirate. The post itself is huge, and it details why the internet would have become a land basically dominated by robots. A place where true and organic content has been replaced by a sterile and lifeless environment. Some parts we can say are nonsense, with completely senseless ideas and without any evidence to support them. For example, this part here where he says that the United States government is committed to manipulating the entire world population through artificial intelligence. Or maybe that a lot of YouTubers, politicians, and actors aren't real, and that people, events, and supposedly real news would be completely made up. But amidst the exaggerations in rhetoric and the clueless guesses, some parts of the dead internet theory actually make sense, and lead us to a series of intriguing questions involving the web nowadays. So let's go over some data that will help us better understand this subject. At the moment I'm recording this video, over 5 billion and 300 million people in the world have access to the internet. That means that practically 2 out of every 3 human beings on planet Earth can connect to the internet. So just imagine the amount of data that is being shared all the time. Just so you get an idea, every minute there are over 500 hours of videos being posted on YouTube, 60,000 photos being published on Instagram, and 200 million emails being sent. This can lead us to believe that we have control over the internet, that human activity is predominant, and that it will remain so indefinitely. But there are experts in this subject who say just the opposite. It's the case of Timothy Shoup from the Institute for Future Studies in Copenhagen, Denmark. He predicts that by 2030, over 99% of internet content will be generated by artificial intelligence. And you might think that's an exaggeration and that it's impossible for that to happen in such a short time. Well, I must say that we're not that far from it nowadays. I collected info on the year 2021, the same year as the well-known manifesto on the theory of the dead internet, and they are in a report released by Barracuda. Based on this report, an astonishing 64% of the entire internet traffic at the present time is already being generated by robots. Taking into account that the majority of this traffic is generated by malevolent bots, that truly resembles a sci-fi flick. Evil robots are what we call robots that send spam, spread viruses, and try to overload websites to take services offline or discover passwords through brute force, testing thousands of combinations per second until they find the correct option. And there are also the good robots, which assist us in searching for results in research, automating posts on websites, and managing pages on social networks. And in the midst of this battle of robots, humans were responsible for only the remaining 36% of internet information traffic in 2021, as reported by Barracuda. And from then on, other studies have brought similar results and even caught the attention of those who closely follow this kind of subject. In 2022, for example, the billionaire Elon Musk was taken aback by these data, and he reacted to one of these surveys with a striking statement. He stated, !! From then on, Musk began monitoring bot prevalence on Twitter, so much that when he attempted to purchase the social network, the negotiation nearly failed due to a controversy regarding the number of bots on the site. Musk said he would give up on the purchase because Twitter didn't want to disclose the percentage of robotic accounts on the platform. He even stated that he would only buy Twitter if the company proved that the number was less than 5%, but he was suspicious that it would be closer to 20%, and some experts suggested it could even reach 80%. In any case, Elon Musk ultimately purchased the company, and despite that, it appears that the problem of robot infestation has only grown in magnitude. Simply utilize Twitter these days and you will understand what I am referring to. Or should I say X? And that is because in 2023, Twitter started compensating users for the number of views that each user receives on their posts. And with that, some users started seeing the social network as a new goldmine, and they created fake profiles that post artificial content just to attract engagement. Now, what they all have in common is the blue check mark, since in order to receive money, you need to pay a subscription to X. However, robot invasions happen on other social networks too. You may have received automated messages with ads in your Instagram DMs. To try to reduce this issue, Facebook has deleted over 5 billion fake accounts in 1 year. And that's more than the number of users on any social network, considering only the profiles that have normal behavior, and also those who make NPC live streams. But despite many people thinking that bots on the internet are recent, they have existed for quite some time. One example is the scam emails, which have been around for decades. The thing is, with the advancement of this kind of technology, robots are replacing interactions with real people. For instance, US influencer Karen Marjorie made a bot for those who want to chat with an artificial version of herself. The paid service on Telegram is like a virtual girlfriend and responds to users' messages exactly as if it were the influencer. And that was possible thanks to over 2,000 hours of artificial intelligence training so that the robot could learn in detail what her personality is like. Another renowned example is Mila Sofia. For her 100K-plus followers, she portrays herself as a 24-year-old girl living in Finland. She shares pictures at the beach while traveling, working out, and doing everything like a normal blogger, with the small difference that she doesn't exist. Sofia isn't a real person, she's actually an artificial digital influencer. Aside from being really bizarre because these are harmless uses of fake profiles using artificial intelligence, much more serious is when robots are used, for example, to attack authorities or spread fake news. The American website NewsGuard, which is focused on combating misinformation on the internet, conducted a survey showing that over 100 companies unknowingly pay for advertising on news websites controlled by robots. An example that NewsGuard uses, in fact, is from a Brazilian website. The page that supposedly was created to share news about jobs is so fake and poorly made that some articles go like this. Sorry, but as an AI language model, I can't access external links, but based on the URL, it appears to be an internship position located in Sergipe, Brazil. In other words, there aren't even professionals who review the content to realize that such a ridiculous mistake has been made, even revealing the strategy behind these websites. And the worst part is the creators profit from the ads on these pages. The worst part is that nothing prevents view numbers from being inflated. Accesses to pages can also be done by robots. In other words, it's possible that many companies and businesses are having both good and bad news. The good news is they're getting a lot of engagement with content generated by AI, but the bad news is this engagement comes from traffic also generated by AI. So cool, apparently we turned the internet into an amusement park where robots create content for other robots to consume. It's kind of like the plot of Westworld, or maybe not. Westworld is a bit heavier. Some new artificial intelligence tools have been trained with data generated by other artificial intelligence tools. It's like a snowball that can grow exponentially, meaning that there will be more and more synthetic content, and they will serve as the foundation for the creation of new synthetic content. This surplus of robotic material is detrimental to the development of artificial intelligences. A study conducted by Rice and Stanford universities in the United States made that very clear to us. They showed that generative artificial intelligence tools, which create images, for example, can be hindered precisely because of the large number of images made by robots. These photos show people who don't exist. Each one of them was generated from the synthesis of previous photos. So notice how, little by little, the quality of the images is getting worse. It's like a kind of loop that artificial intelligence gets stuck in and ends up ruining its own work. It is probable that at a certain point, the AIs themselves will assist in finding ways to solve this problem. But how can they accomplish that? Well, to overcome the decrease in image quality generated by artificial intelligence, the strategies include diversifying training sets, transferring styles and domains, incorporating real-world data, enhancing generative models, and continuous evaluation with human feedback. Introducing variety in data and optimizing algorithms aims to avoid artificiality and bias, ensuring realistic and relevant images. And that's not me saying it. The one who wrote this response that I just told you was ChatGPT itself, so it must know what it's talking about. By the way, bot responses are so complete that they can surpass the Turing test, created to evaluate if a robot can display human-like behavior indistinguishable from a human. And this advanced behavior of the bots has already caused, in reality, a fear that is known as inversion. The moment when algorithms would start to interpret that the behavior of robots is real and that people's actions on the internet are artificial. At this point, humans would definitely lose control of the web to the robots. It would be a one-way path that would completely exclude human presence in the virtual world. The dead internet would stop existing as one of those theories from peculiar internet sites and would transform into a harsh, absolute, and unavoidable reality. But of course, that's just a hypothetical scenario and not at all likely to happen. You can relax.
Unless I'm a robot trying to convince you, you probably wouldn't even know.